So ready.
In 1925, WSM in Nashville, Tennessee started this thing called the Barn Dance. And in 1925, at WLS in Chicago, they started the same thing. The National Barn Dance, they called that one, though, in Chicago. WLS was owned by Sears Roebuck Company, and those call letters for the radio station stood for World's Largest Store, WLS, back in 1925. They had purchased what they call a 10,000 watt transmitter, so they're bouncing a signal, a clear channel signal, they're bouncing an AM signal all across the Midwest. Likewise, they're doing that down in Nashville at the Barn Dance. 1925, they hired a fellow named Uncle Dave Macon. Anybody ever hear him?
Yeah,
Uncle Dave. He was the Dixie Dewdrop, they called him. And his band was known as the Fruit Jar Drinkers, to give you an idea of their offstage and onstage recreational proclivities. But that WSM down in Nashville, and they had that barn dance, and they hired Uncle Dave Macon, and he was like the star of the show, and they had a bunch of other, rural folks that come in and play, and they'd song and dance and whatnot. WSM was owned by the National Life Insurance Company, and WSM stood for We Shield Millions. 1927, something strange happened. They had this opera program on this WSM, 1925, and 1926, and that opera program played before this barn dance. Well, one day the announcer says, well, we've heard 2 hours of that fine opera, and now we're going to bring you some fine Grand Ole Opry. And that's how the Grand Ole Opry got its name, 1927. Uncle Dave played with them until 1957 when he passed away in his 80s. Banjo player. It was one of his favorite songs. He played this quite often on the Grand Ole Opry, a tune called Sail Away Ladies.